how can something this cold be so cozy?
I've always been a fan of the snow. And I mean, many people complain about it, but I try to find a way to make it fun.
With a lot of hard work, ingenuity, and some helping hands, Blake Dixon is raising the bar on igloos in South Euclid.
In middle school, I always had dreams of building like a snow castle or igloo or something.
Every winter, Blake worked to bring that vision to life.
I used to have to bring him, tell him to come in. It was amazing. He was just crazy in the snow. He loved it. It was like a moth to flame.
After years of perfecting his engineering, Blake was able to build his biggest igloo yet. And I gotta be honest, as his cousin, I'm really proud.
It makes you appreciate winter. He loves the snow so much, and he's done just a wonderful job with these igloos.
Since starting last Friday, the job hasn't been without some challenges.
When we first started working on it, all we had was a pile of snow, and then we were working from the inside to pull it all out. The top collapsed, and with some ingenuity from Blake, as well as a little bit of persistence, we were able to reconstruct the dome and put it all back together.
This igloo features a full seating area, hallway, and second room. Blake says it's been putting a lot of smiles on people's faces, which was his goal.
It's to give people a reason to enjoy what we have that no other places have. Like, you don't get this in Florida. You can't get this.
Wow. So how many people does it take to fill an igloo? There's got to be a joke in there somewhere.
Let's try it out.
I counted 7 adults, 2 kids, and plenty of room.
This is amazing, Blake.
Oh, thanks.
Believe it or not, Blake isn't finished.
I want to put in a tall chimney where I could put a fire into and really have it toasty.
One recycling can mold at a time. His friend Ed and girlfriend Joy are now helping him make the blocks for the chimney.
I would sell this for $500,000.
All jokes aside, this is one cool new home.
I give it a thumbs up.
In South Euclid, Alex Stokes, Fox 8 News.